In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use Blender and Photoshop to create this heaven image. S to scale. S and Z to scale in the Z axis. Let's add the array modifier. Ctrl 3 to subdivide. Ctrl R to add two loop cuts by using the mouse wheel up. Let's use the scale tool to separate them apart. I'll apply the modifier and add a new cube. In edit mode, I'll select this side face and move it to create a support bar mesh. In object mode, Shift D to duplicate and Z to move it upward. We need one more cube. G and Z to move on the Z axis. I'll extrude and scale the top face like this. Let's add a Boolean mesh. I'll use a cylinder. S and Z to scale in the Z axis. In order to open the gate, we need to move the mesh's origin first. Let's shift-select all moving parts and Ctrl-J to join them. In edit mode, let's select this face. Shift-S to move the 3D cursor there. After that, move the origin to the 3D cursor. We can rotate the gate at the top viewport. Let's join all the meshes and mirror them. This time, we need to press Shift C to reset the 3D cursor's location and move the origin to the 3D cursor. Let's set up the render scene. I'll add a spotlight. S, and Z, to scale in the Z axis. Let's also add a material. Time to change the world nodes to volume scatter. Please adjust the light strength any way you like. Depending on what the final strength is, the door will be more or less visible later. Stronger the light, less visible the image will be once it gets imported and edited in Photoshop. I have opened a cloud image and the render image. Ctrl A to select all and Ctrl C to copy. Let's paste the image to the clouds. We can use these tools to create a professional quality composition in Photoshop. Please notice how the render image gets overlapped and changed each time a new option is selected. We can use Photoshop's adjustment tools above to further enhance the image like this. By the way, I won't be using the adjustments for the final image. This is only to show you how the image can be further enhanced. Let's select the render layer and Control T to expand the size a bit. I'll show you what each adjustment does. They're cool, but I won't be using them for this project. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.